time.
You are as thick as they come, sweetness. This is my personal playhouse, and you don't have an invite. Has that wriggler eaten your brain already? You'll go nicely with Mayrina. She's all...
What's that? What is this place?
You feel crushing waves of fear as the presence within the door recoils. It can't let people through, not again. Images flash. A man cowering, a bag open at his feet. Gold coins spilling onto the floor. His cries for mercy are cut short as the hag slices into him, dismembering him painstakingly, limb by limb. She cackles. The man's remain becoming the twisted flea. You feel it cry. A scene appears in your mind. Weapons brandished, they charge into the hag's lair.
You let them in? Naughty. That's a decade for each. You're mine for 30 more years, Petal.
You see an image of blue skies and sunshine as the door shudders a warning. Run. Its form flickers, and you realize that the door is transparent. Fear rushes through you as the door shakes and remains firmly closed. As the presence huddles within.
Stop! No, no! Don't look! Mustn't look, mustn't see! I see it! I see what's...
You realize there's magic at work. Sometimes...
Me! Dead! Dead! Flesh rotten, bone shining! All future! No. Gods, don't hurt me! Oh, please, monster! My mind dripping! Flesh peeling! Mind flayer! Ah! No! I'm sorry.
No intention of letting that happen.
Wait!
More for me?
Don't look. Don't! Stop. Please. Please!
A thief who tried to steal from Auntie. Now the good little pet guards my own, my gentle Lauren. He wished to know what was to come.
Stop. Please. Please. Away.
This poor dear wished never to lay eyes on her family again.
My dearest Efren, he begged me to call a deadly disease that ravaged him.
Away! Don't look.
Victory awaits.
Thank you. to do it.
Give up now.
Oh dear. Someone's left a trap out for us. Traps. How considerate. Oh dear. Someone's left. traps about.
At least things have stayed interesting.
No one. Oh dear. Someone's left a trap out for us.
This place is hungry for blood.
Is that blood? No, never mind.
What's the story?
Enough waiting. I crave blood.
In the cage.
Don't touch me.
Dance.
You come to my home interfering. I'll rip your spine out your asshole. I'll use your blood. I'll keep you alive.
Save her.
go.
Don't waste a step.
Kick up, come on! Bash her brains out!
No surrender. No time to waste. Nothing will stand in my way.
This'll help.
Get your bloody head in!
taking position. My path be true. But to keep going. With haste. Good idea, Carl. Count on me. Gods are watching me.
Wait! Oh, wait just a tick! Killing me is a waste of time. I'll find a way to return, but it's unpleasant. So how about we be civilized? Hold your horses. Let me leave with the girl. You want to be stronger, tougher? So just let me keep the girl and her babe.
Please. She's dreaming it.
It's your choice, sweetness. You greedy little ballocks. Fine. Here. I'll not soon forget this, sweetness. You have my word.
But the deal. What about my husband?
Deal's off, you dumb cow. Not that it matters. I'll find a... I can set up shop elsewhere. People always need lotions and potions. If I ever see you again, bye-bye, pet.
There better be a soft bedroll in my near future.
Well, that's a bummer.
Maggots will be done.
I accidentally killed her. There's nothing to loot. That's so annoying.
Take my pick.
I really wanted to kill the hag. I didn't want to letting her go. Seemed like a mistake.
Over here.
Should be interesting.
Little trick.
Nothing will stand in my way. No hesitation.
my best interest.
Jimmy on the go.
A better position.
Can't even catch my breath.
Taking position.
Incoming.
Yes, here. A fine opportunity.
Time to push my luck again.
In my best interest. Oh, enough waiting. I crave blood.
pick. going.
Another crate.
Could go for a good meal. What a charmer.
What's this?
good looking. No chance.
Someone there? A crooked touch. Weapon blueprints. They call for Susabark. If only I knew where to find some.
Battle.
Soldier.
She's so strong. Good thing she can throw stuff at people.
Let's get going.
Wandered into a forbidden area. You sense it might be time to leave.
Everything. Light on my feet.
Tormentor. I'm heating up.
This will do.
Embrace pride, reject vanity, especially when gazing at your own reflection. I'd have to be a lot smaller to squeeze in there.
Stars, two eyes in the middle.
Quickly, then.
No. All stars and two eyes in the middle.
That might be worth a look.
Just so.
Never a dull moment.
Indolence breeds madness.
Thank you.
Do we have to spend so long poking about down here? I'd much rather be outside with the sun on my skin.
You've only just come to the sun and you're already nostalgic. If you're going to complain the whole way, by all means, return topside. You could use the color.
Let's move.
Damn, it's good to be alive.
Careful. There are traps about. Easy.
beautiful. Lethal. The Underdark is everything I thought it would be.
And I... This environ seems worthy of a Yankee warrior's estimate.
Ah, to be deemed worthy by the great Lizelle of Kresh Kalir.
Continue as you have, Karlak, and you will achieve the same.
Be shy.
Keep your distance, darling. A quick rummage.
So much looting. I'm gonna be freaking rich by the end of this. save before I do something and then die or something happens. Wait on that one.
All right.
I'd love to, thanks.
What now?
Time to waste.
Whatever's ahead, even more intriguing.
Okay. I'll take that.
I'm exhausted. Better find somewhere to camp soon.
Oh, shut it. Mei-chan. Damn, we can't take the moonstone.
Making me sweat.
Might be worth a look. No chance.
fungal spores are everywhere.
Taking position.
This is worth the cost.
This just got very interesting.
Just like old times. While they're distracted.
Easy these days.
Thank you. You won't expect this. We'll just take it.
Stay vigilant. There are traps here.
Oh, that's a low roll.
Be careful. There are traps about.
So I think it ends up being a plus 12 max.
Over there.
Can you believe this is my first time in the Underdark? The world is so big!
The year, Tenir. The place, sleepy little town called Baldur's Gate. I was a kid looking for a way to fill my days and make some cash when I fell into the wrong crowd. Through the jigs and the reels, he made a deal with Zariel behind my back. You know, she put this thing in my chest and set me to work. Well, to war. I learned quick how to stay alive. 10 years of that. Guy named Gortash, politician, I guess I was naive to think everything he got up to was above board. Sometimes I'm jealous of that girl. Ugh, to feel so invincible again.
Sounds boring.
Yes!
Don't burn yourself.
Watch your back.
Mark of the Centurion, I believe. Brigands for hire. Let's have a look.
Careful, I bite.
Indolence breeds madness.
Extra attack? Nice.
Open up. Take heed. I see a trap.
doesn't work.
What do you mean it doesn't work?
Doesn't work.
Yes, my friend?
I was just settling in and reviewing my latest findings. Mind flayers, cultists, and of course... Finding is my job, my friend. If there's anything in the world worth knowing, I'm practically...
The druid Halson had some kind of mind flayer specimen in a jar in his quarters.
A rep here, on the Sword Coast. Impossible. That can't be. Tell me, have you noticed any residual psionic malaise since the...
That's quite impossible. You'd have undergone seramorphosis by now.
If what you say were true...
You! Infected,
isn't it?
If I just peer in your eye...
Oh, dear sweet gods!
If we managed it, we... I'll need to research the particulars.
Yes. Yeah. All right, let's see something crazy.
One horn, the stink of Avernus, Advocatus Diaboli.
Well, I'll be gods damned. The blade of frontiers. Thought I'd...
Karlak, the archdevil Zariel's gladiator, come to burn the Sword Coast to ash.
If by met, you mean hoofing it through the hells with this fucker on my tail?
Shut it, devil. I know your kind. A heart darker than a shadow's nightmares. You'd cut a child's throat just to taste the blood.
A devil? I didn't take the blade for a fool. I'm...
A great fire roars through you. The fire of the first hell. You are Karlak, tearing through demons across a blood-red landscape of fire and volcanic cinder. The front lines of the Blood War. With every swing of her axe, Karlak fulfills Mistress Zariel's purpose.
Proof! Clear as summer sky! It's over, Karlak! It's time you feel the sting of the blade!
I've tried to tell you, I'm not what you think I am!
Another vision. Karlak's blade rays slicing through devils, Zariel's servants, as her eyes dart around, seeking escape. Will shudders with Karlak's desperation. She is a victim of the Blood War, not an agent of it.
By Baldurin's helm, No, I will not be tricked.
You saw the truth. I may be an effective soldier, but I never wanted to serve Zariel. Legged it away from her the first chance I got.
And yet you served.
Will catches his breath and his lips straighten. Sheer dread twists his face.
No! Devils cannot be trusted!
Would you listen to sense? This doesn't have to end badly for either of us.
You know monsters better than anyone. Can't you look in my eyes and see I'm not a devil?
You don't know what this means. You don't know what you're asking me to do.
I'm asking you to live, Will. I don't want to hurt you. And to be frank, I'd rather not find out how the Blade got his name. I swear to you, on all I am not what you think.
Shit! Shit. You really are no devil, are you? I've been deceived.
Yeah.
Oh, thank the gods. Thought I was gonna have to take your head.
You would have died in the attempt. But there have been enough threats today.
Truce then, eh?
Aye. Truce. I see the good in you, Karlak. I promise not to lose sight of...
Good thing for Will that Karlak called a truce. A tiefling that mighty would shred him to pieces and burn the remains. What did you need?
Glad Will saw sense. Even more glad he decided to stick around. Takes a pretty slick mover to track down old Karlak. Fair. But still, the man's got a reputation for being...
Anybody else? Anybody else? Cool. Damn, look at you, dude. Still here, huh? Where's old Skelly? Wait, for real, where is old Skelly? Uh-oh. Is he not down here with us? Ah. Why are you... Oh.
Thank goodness that's all dealt with. The odds are stacked high enough against us already. No need to turn on each other.
That is most gratifying to hear. May I?
What does this do?
Perhaps I'm not conveying the urgency of the situation. It's incredibly, world-shatteringly important you give me a suitable artifact. Please. Of course. I would hate for you to think...
Okay, let's see. I'm gonna just go searching through my magic chest. Wasn't it, like, right over here somewhere? Shit. Oh, I can give him. Shit.
What's on your mind? Apart from fight,
that is most gratifying to hear. May I?
Where'd it go?
Thank you.
Listen, I need to speak to you, to all of you. It would be unconscionable of me to remain silent. I might just be about to remedy that. You have to know who I was. What I am is a walking shadow of the promise of what one might call a wizard prodigy. And from an early age, could not only control the weave, but such was my skill that it earned me the attention of the mother of magic herself. She revealed herself to me and she became my teacher. In time, she became my muse. Oh, yes. We enjoyed each other's company. Body. You see, no matter how powerful a wizard we mortals can become, Mistra keeps us in check. There are boundaries she doesn't let us cross. Yet, every time I sought to cross her boundaries. I tried to convince her. I pouted. I pleaded. Swore my ambition, but inconceivable as it seems to me now, I shared a bed with a goddess, and yet I wasn't satisfied. We come now to the crux of my folly. Shall I share the story behind it, or would you rather head straight to its sordid finale? Very well. Once upon a very long time ago, a mighty lord lived in a tower. I'll save his history for another time, but the gist of it is that he sought to usurp the goddess of magic so that he almost managed, but not quite. And his entire empire, Netheril, came crashing down around it. The magic that was unleashed that day was phenomenal. Even the weave itself could not withstand the onslaught. It fractured, then shattered, and all magic was lost to the mortal realms. She restored the weave, reuniting all its scattered shards. Or so I thought, until in the course of my studies, I learned of a book. Netherese, what if, I thought, what if, after all this time, I could return this lost part of herself to the goddess? You know me. I was certain that this deed of raw power, draped in romance, would convince Mistra to take me by the hand and welcome me into her hitherto. I was mistaken. I obtained the fabled book and took it into my study.
Here. Place your hand over my heart. Let me show you.
You feel the tadpole quiver as you realize Gale is letting you in, into the dark. You see through Gale's eyes, staring down the corridors of a dread memory. A book, bound. And inside there are no pages, only a swirling mass. Its teeth, its claws. It's unstoppable as it digs through and becomes part of you. And gods, is it ever hungry.
Thankfully, the moment I absorbed the fragment wasn't enough to kill me outright. This Netherese blight, this orb, for lack of a better word, is balled up inside my chest. And it needs to be. As long as I absorb traces of the weave from potent enough sources, it remains quiet. Were it ever to fully destabilize, however.
Rather worse, actually.
I will erupt.
I don't know the exact magnitude of the eruption, but given my studies of Netherese magic,
I'd say even a fragment as small as the... It'd level a city the size of Waterdeep.
We might chance upon a king's collection of magical artifacts around the corner. We might cross paths with a miracle round the bend. Then again, all of this, it must feel like a betrayal. Say the word, and we'll part ways. That is, you truly are a soul that steals my own. From all my, I thank you all. I understand if you stand, I stand at a precipice. But if you do not give up hope, neither shall I.
Now.
Even I am
I like how it says character sheet. It's funny. Alright, I'm gonna give this to Gale. Oh, that's why.
You've been witness to a pantomime, I'm sorry to say. And I've played my part all too poorly. I can say only this. Karlak's not the only one who's had a villain's knife held. One night soon, when we make camp, the veil will be lifted, and I'll pay my penance. You're not in any danger, I promise.
Still breathing, despite everything.
My friend!
How do you fare? My research...
It's not too deep. Just behind the orbital socket. I could attempt a... I assure you, I've dreamt of it 1,000 times over.
Vola carefully holds one of your eyes open and begins to prod uncertainly with the needle.
The pain is worth it.
The needle finds the gap between eyeball and socket. Volo frowns and begins to push. Pain shoots through your body as the needle snags on your optic nerve.
I think I have it!
The needle seesaws back and forth, plucking the nerve like a harp string.
Oh, bother. There's some obstacle in the way. I shall need a more robust implement.
Volo carefully withdraws the needle from your eye. Then, reaching into his bag, he produces an ice pick. Volo slowly brings the ice pick closer to your eye.
Now, don't.
Cold metal presses against the skin beneath your brow. And then, tap, tap, stab.
Do you feel that? Ha! I think we have the blighter on the run! I agree. It's a feisty... I agree. It's a feisty critter. Just a little further. Drat.
He pauses, looks down at your eye.
There appears to be an amount of cosmetic damage. Please, try not to overexert yourself. You're in a... I can't help but feel partly responsible. Take this. A far superior relic to that old... Try it on for size. And I'm sure you'll sort out your little brain problem one way or another. Far away from here, if you've a heart. Terribly sorry, my friend. Ta!
I can now see invisibility in one of my eyes. It is fogged. Let me see what I look like. Can I change the way the eye looks? Scarring, genitals, eye color. Oh no. I can see invisible people, but I'm SOL for my eyes. It's worth it. It's worth it. It's worth it. Right? It's worth it. Right? Right? I think it's worth it. It's worth it? Yeah, it's worth it. Oh, buddy. Oh, buddy. Oh, pal. I feel like, Rudius from Jobless Reincarnation. He has a very similar thing happen to him. Anyways, I'm tired. I have done so much today. This is my second recording for the day. So, all that being said, I'm gonna save. Yeah. I have the invisibility eye. It's gonna be very useful.
Also, my character kind of looks like a goddess right now. Anyways, pretty much all of my characters have, like, max load because I'm... Oh, hey. Characters are OP, 82 health, 64 health, 62 health, 88 health. Damn, Lazel has more health than our barbarian here.
Copper for your thoughts. Gives me energy, power. If I'm excited at all, angry, nervous, I try not to think about it. I still think about it constantly, but... You know, I try. One of these days, I'll sort the whole infernal affair out, get myself cooled off, start making up for lost, but not today.
Okay, if I ever make a male character, honestly, that's what's gonna happen. She's gonna be my third character, yep. God, I made such a gorgeous freaking character in our four-person playthrough. Or our three-person playthrough. Anyways, thanks for watching. It's been a long night. I will see you all next time.